Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. Guys, in this video, I will be discussing the Capgemini interview experience. This interview happened today only, that is on 13th January 2022. So guys, make sure that you watch this video till the end and do not skip any question that has been discussed in this video. Guys, I have discussed a lot of Capgemini interview experiences on my channel. You can find all the Capgemini interview experiences under this playlist. I will give the link of this playlist in the I button or in the description box. Make sure to visit it if you are preparing for the Capgemini interviews. And guys, those interview experiences on which I am not able to make a video, I upload them on my blog. So again, the link of the blog also I will give in the description box. There also Capgemini interview experiences have been posted. So if you are preparing, kindly check out all the things that I will give in the description box after watching this video. So guys, if you have not subscribed to this channel till now, please subscribe it. And guys, now let's start this video. And before starting the video, please hit the like button. Okay, so guys, the date of the interview was 23rd January 2022. The branch of my friend is CSC. The duration of the entire interview was 25 minutes. The first question that was asked from him was introduce yourself. And guys, in 9 out of 10 interviews, this is the first question that is asked from the candidate. So guys, in this particular question, you can tell that what you have done in your college life, like what projects you know, what technologies you have worked on, what internships you have done, about your certifications, your extracurricular activities, and many more things you can tell the interviewer in this question. But try to tell only those things in which you are comfortable in answering, because it might happen that the next few questions are from introduce yourself question only. So I hope you will be able to prepare for this question. So guys, now moving to the next question. Next question was, do you know Java? So yes, my friend knew Java and he said yes. But guys, if you do not know a particular language, let's suppose you know Python, and interviewer asks you, do you know Java? So you can simply say no, that I do not know Java, but you can ask me questions from Python or C++, any language in which you are comfortable in. But for technical interviews, you must be prepared with at least one language to answer for the questions. So I hope this question is also clear to you. Next is, what is a constructor? Now guys, constructor, again, it is a very basic question that can be asked from you in an interview. Constructor is a special type of method which is used to initialize the objects. Every time an object is created using the new keyword in Java, at least one constructor is called. It calls a default constructor if there are no constructor available in the class. So I hope now you have understood that what is a constructor. Constructor is helpful in initializing the objects. Like suppose we have a class and we have two variables in it, class variables A and B. So we can initialize both variables value using the constructor. So I hope this question is clear to you. Okay. Now, the next question is, explain the OOPS concepts. Again, guys, it is a very important as well as commonly asked interview question. So explain OOPS concepts. So there are basically four OOPS concepts. One is abstraction, encapsulation, polymorphism, and inheritance. And guys, if you want to know in detail that how you will have to explain these things in the interview, then I have made a separate video on my channel in which I have discussed the four pillars of OOPS. In that video, I have discussed each and every concept in detail with the help of an example that how you will have to tell it to the interviewer. So I hope this question is clear to you. I will give that video link in the I button or in the description box. Make sure to check it. Okay. Next question was, define method overloading. Now guys, method overloading is, if a class has multiple methods having the same name but different in parameters, it is known as method overloading. So we all know that in a method, there are two things. One is the method name, another one is the argument that we pass. So if there are two methods in a class with same name and different parameters, then it is known as method overloading. Now there are two ways to overload the methods in Java. First one is by changing the number of arguments. So you can see that these are the two methods, both name are add, but there are difference in the argument. That is, in the first method, there is only two arguments that are passing, and in the second function, there are three arguments that have been passed. So by this way also we can achieve method overloading. But again, there is one more way of achieving it, by changing the data types. So let's suppose there are two methods, and again both of them are having two parameters only. So first one having is int A, int B, and second one is having double A and double B. So this is by this phenomena also we can perform the method overloading. So I hope this thing is clear to you. This question is clear to you. Next is, define method overriding. So guys, again, whenever method overloading will be asked from you, method overriding will be also asked. So these are interchangeable terms. Again, you must know the difference of method overloading and method overriding. I will give the link of method overriding in description box. You can visit this link and see for yourself that what does it, what is method overriding. So I hope this question is clear to you. Next is, what is database management system? Because database management system is nothing but it is a software for storing and retrieving users' information by considering appropriate security measures. It consists of a group of programs which manipulate the database. So again guys, in large industries there are big large data that is present for the customer so again, we if we have to store details for certain things, we must have a database. And how we can store things in the database? We can simply store them in database with the help of certain commands. So I hope all of you know the CRUD operations in database, like create, delete, update. So all these are the commands that help us in storing our data and manipulating the data in the database management system. So I hope this question is clear to you. Next and the last question of this video, of this interview, was, explain the difference between foreign key and primary key. So again guys, these are both very important terms when considered in database. So if any question is asked from database, these primary key will be the first question that will be asked from you. So please prepare this particular thing very carefully. So difference between primary key and foreign key. So first of all, a primary key is used to ensure data in a specific column is unique. So if we give a constraint of a primary key in a column, that means that column cannot contain duplicate values and that column cannot contain any null values. This is the main agenda of the primary key. Now foreign key. A foreign key is a column or a group of columns in a relation database table that provides a link between data in two tables. Now guys, let's suppose we have to fetch our data, using two tables. Then how we will be joining those two tables? We will be joining those two tables with the help of a foreign key. So if we have to retrieve our data from more than one table, so then we will use the concept of a foreign key. I hope this difference is clear to you. So guys, whenever a difference is asked to you in an interview, kindly mention at least 2 points of difference about the fields that have been asked. So these were all the questions which are asked from this candidate in this interview. The branch of this candidate was CSC, and the entire duration of the interview was 20 to 25 minutes. And guys, if you wish to prepare and wish to know the more Capgemini interviews that are going on recently, please comment down and like this video. I will make more such videos in future. And guys, already there are many interview experiences that I've already covered on my YouTube channel in the playlist. So you can also watch that videos also for your reference. The links are in the description box. Thank you for watching this video.